Becky G. By the way, I do think you were on my flight yesterday. They got held up for 4 hours on the tarmac.
Oh, my God. Yeah. You were on that torturous adventure as well?
My ass was sitting in the back next to the toilet.
Oh, it was not fun.
Rethinking everything about life.
Yeah, it was like way too... We could have gone... We might as well have gone to New York.
Yeah, I would.
That was how long we were on the plane.
Literally, we could have driven here.
Yeah, I know.
It was a little stupid.
It's all good.
But Becky G is here backstage at the Billboard Music Awards 1. You must come into our show and have a real discussion on music.
Yes.
These things are so short. So, like, they always yell at me if I talk for a little bit too long.
It's all good. Don't worry about it.
It's just the way they work. But, one, you got a lot going on. You got a lot career-wise. You have a lot going on in life.
Yes.
You're here, though, presenting. Billboards mean something to music.
Yes.
Right? It's
100%.
Chart position, being on the chart, striving for it. What goals are you setting for yourself? For this year and for the next 2020.
Year, I mean, to be honest, all the numbers and stuff, like, that stuff's really cool. Like, I kind of got a little bit caught up in the whole, like, being a stream queen, right? Like, oh, Becky G got 1 billion views on a music video. Like, those numbers are so massive. But it doesn't compare to just, like, making good music that you love. And I feel like that is one of my goals always now moving forward. I think this year, to be able to release an EP that really represents me, my message, the style that I've created for myself as an artist is really important. And really just taking control of my career. Like, that's my goal, is to really be able to own and take responsibility for everything that it is that I'm doing, because it's not under anyone else's terms anymore. And that's, like, so liberating and just so badass. Like, it's such an empowering feeling.
It's empowering. It also could be a little stressful, right? Because there's accountability solely on yourself.
Yes.
You can't blame anybody anymore.
Yeah.
But you've been doing this a long time, so you know that this is what you're meant to be doing inside
totally.
Of you.
Totally. And I think, you know, I'm young enough to go, you know, high risk, high reward. Like, we're in Vegas, we got to gamble sometimes. And if I'm going to bet on anybody, I would bet on myself any day. I feel like I've been doing this for many years now, although I'm only 22 and I know I'm still so young and have so much more to learn. Getting signed at 14 years old and having such big dreams and then trusting, you know, people who want to help you but maybe not in the ways that are beneficial to your career was a huge learning curve for me. And I feel like leading up to this very moment, I'm getting kind of the opportunity to start all over again, but it's a good opportunity.
Well, I mean, that must mean something.
Oh, it means everything.
You've been working towards this.
Yeah.
You've just wanted to have control.
Yeah.
What have you learned from not having control that allows you to now need it and require it and deserve it?
I think the biggest thing for me is, like, you know, I'm a consumer of music. Like, I love music. I'm a huge fan of music. And how the audience consumes music nowadays is, like, we don't like fake things. We don't like manufactured cookie cutter stuff. And I think, you know, at the time I got so caught up in what the industry was saying was great and what would be considered successful, as to where, you know, not paying attention to the fact that the audience was saying, like, yo, you started off as Becky from the Block, as, like, a 14-year-old rapper doing rap covers on YouTube. Like, what are you doing singing pop music? This doesn't make sense. And it wasn't clicking. And I think that was the biggest lesson I learned, is, like, authenticity, honesty with your music, living your truth. Doesn't matter if you're the biggest artist in the room. If you're doing that, that is what you can consider a successful artist.
Ooh. Yes. Amen.
Yeah.
Is there a date for this EP?
No date yet. There's a lot of cooks in the kitchen, I like to say.
Okay.
So I'm trying the best that I can. I know my fans are always like, you always say soon. I'm like, yeah, like, fast forward 5 years later, we're still here, like, waiting. Literally, it's a meme. It's like the SpongeBob thing when they're like, 10 years later. That's me. I am that meme all day. So for sure this year.
Do you have
for
records
sure this year.
Done?
Yes.
Whoa.
Yeah, I have. I mean, at this point, I feel like I could have done release already, like, 10 albums, because as an artist, you're just constantly creating, you're cutting songs, you're collaborating. I think in this year alone, Shirin, how many releases have we had this year? Yeah, we've had 5 releases since the beginning of 2019. And then last year, we had something like 15, 16 releases. So, like, for me, it's just like, keep just putting them out there. Whatever sticks, sticks. But as long as you love it, like, that's dope.
That's what matters. Becky G, appreciate you deeply. Really
Thank
nice
you.
Talking to you. You got to come
here
and hang out, please. Like, I have so many other questions, and I've obviously been listening to you
I'm
music
sure
for
we'll
a
get an opportunity to sit down and really, like,
dive on
get in. Get deep, yeah.
Becky G?
I would love that.
appreciate you.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Same here.